Alright, are you ready for the word today? I am ready to share God's word today, and am thankful for you being here today. I'd like to preach on a subject that I don't normally preach about, but I want to preach on the blessing of being single, okay? Obviously, I'm not going to be speaking much out of my personal experience because I've been married for 40 years, believe it or not. But I can and will preach the word of God today. And I have some funny quotes from singles today, all right? These are what some singles have said. They said, "I like being single. I'm always there when I need me." Another single said, "There's only one thing harder than living alone, and that's to live with another person." So married people, don't nudge your wife or husband, all right? Another guy said, "I'm not a single man. I'm in a long-term relationship with action, adventure, and fun." All right, and I really like this one. They say, "Yes, I'm single," and then they give an acrostic for the word single, S-I-N-G-L-E. Stress is now gone, life is easier. Okay, so let's hear it for the singles today, all right. And you know, being single is not really a new dilemma, it's an old dilemma. And the question becomes, if someone could just go over there and just hit the light switch, you ever notice how to turn it on? We're not all the way on here today, all right. Excuse me while I just take care of the details of life. Anyway, the question becomes, if we're believers, the question becomes, what does the Bible have to say about being single? And how are we as Christians to understand singleness, okay? And so we are all aware of the fact that God has designed the relationship of marriage to be kind of the common expression of human life in an intimate social type of a way. And of course, I just want to kind of preface all of this by saying that marriage is the only relationship in which sexual intimacy can take place at all. Marriage is God's gift and God's design. I believe in that. But let me just say this as well, that it is not the only gift of God. It is not the only design of God. God's design is actually that some people would remain unmarried. Some people would enjoy their singleness, and that's okay. So we're going to jump right into 1 Corinthians 7. Let me just say that everything that I'm going to say today is based upon the Word of God. And interestingly enough, one of the chief authors in the Bible was a guy by the name of Paul the Apostle. How many have ever heard of him, right? Well, did you know that he was a single guy, right? A great man, a godly man, and a single man as well. And this is what he writes in 1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse number 7. He says this, "For I wish that all men," and we could say all women as well, because he says that a little later on. He says, "For I wish that all men were even as myself, as I myself. But each one has his own gift from God. One in this manner and another in that. But I say to the unmarried and to the widows," can I have all the unmarried and widows wave at me for a minute today? All right. "It is good for them if they remain as I am. But if they cannot exercise self-control, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn with passion." And so Paul tells us that he's single, and he says that it's really a blessing to him to be single. And he kind of says, "I just wish everybody had the same gift that I have." And he obviously enjoyed being single. He described it as a gift from God. Of course, as he introduces this entire subject, he does bring this one concession. He says, listen, if you can't have self-control, if you're burning with passion, if you find yourself being tempted, you know, to do things that the Word of God says you shouldn't, then maybe it's better for you to get married. So he does concede that. And then he goes to kind of give his reasoning why he feels like he's able to talk about singleness All right, in 1 Corinthians 7:25, let me read that for you. How many of you tracking with me today? All right. It says, now concerning virgins, I have no commandment from the Lord. Yet I give judgment as one whom the Lord and his mercy has made trustworthy. In other words, Paul is saying, I really can't quote Jesus about this aspect of being single. Jesus didn't say much about being single, but he says, I'm a person that the Lord has put confidence and trust in me, and so I have the Spirit of God, and I'm going to give you my counsel and my advice. And then basically throughout this entire chapter of 1 Corinthians chapter 7, he talks about the reasons why it's a blessing to be single, okay? So I'm going to give you guys 5 reasons why it's a blessing to be single today. And for those of you whom God has blessed with the gift of singleness, these are the very principles which God makes, that God declares why your singleness is so wonderful. All right, how many of you think it's wonderful to be married? Yes, it's also wonderful to be single, okay? And so let me give you these reasons real quickly today. The first reason is